this side, remember I changed the exhaust. That's a felt on the rain. Make sure you use the rain mode while it's raining. So in this case, we can pop this out pretty easy. Okay, apparently you don't need to take anything off of this. Oh yeah, actually right here. See this part? So yep, we need to take that off. I love this, man. And then we might use these too. Let's work on that. So since I changed the exhaust, we have the OEM exhaust pipe. They have something to put in here and adjust it, and then like a bolt. So it goes across and hold in place with this. I don't have it, so I'm not gonna use this. If you wanna, as you see, the cover's kinda high. It's gonna be fine, hopefully. Yeah, that bottom part is gonna rubber against the aftermarket exhaust, which is for many, this is just like a car tip exhaust. It's like a foot long. I think it's at 3.5 3/4 diameter. So I mean, you can go back. I mean, you can get an ID tape, OD tape, I think it is ID tape, and measuring your main exhaust, and then you get your OD on the aftermarket exhaust. And then we are going to take this off. Voila. Pretty cool. In this case, I have to read the manual pretty well because they have a bearing ball. Might be locking something. But the instructions, not the manual, the instructions are pretty clear. So let's open one of these two tamales. This is the kind of like the OEM, the one that you have on the when you buy your bike, the regular one from the front pegs. It's the same model. I mean, what else you can get? The other model, to me, is just, I think it's too expensive just to have them step on it. Okay, so put that, put that. trim. So the little bowl, you gotta place it right here. And you got a two holes, one go through, the other one's like drilled and doesn't go through. So you put in here, okay. I got the right one. This is the left side. Make sure you got the right side. The right side on it. So I'm gonna work on the other side because the other, on the left side goes because the right side, I gotta take it apart and work on it. You take the locking pin. I just messed it up. So let's do it. Let's do it right on this and on the left side. I found it. Just put it on first. Voila. Oh my God. It's so freaking easy. Now I have to go back to the other side. I gotta take everything apart. So if you come across with a situation, the one that I had, because you're desperate like me, that it took me like not even 10 seconds to figure it out, okay? Where you didn't put it looks like a bearing bowl on the drilling hole, you gotta put the spring and then the locking cross key, and then you don't put the little ball in it. Don't forget to put the ball in. So all you gotta do is use a razor blade and once you push it out, you unlock the little lock part, this one right here. So all you gotta do is just use the razor blade, find it in each groove, and just place the razor blade and push it down while you're pulling the cross locking pin. That was easy and fast. All right, let's keep going back to business. So we gotta do the same as the other side, the right side. So put the spring in. Let's get a little bowl. And then so going this way. So as I saw in the instruction, these two holes, you gotta go face forward to the handlebar. Because that's the way the pictures it's showing me. Oh shit. Let me sit down. everything looks good. So make sure that locking bowl, I'm gonna call it locking bowl, it's in the back. It's on the last one right here. And this one right here, not on the front one, the rear one. I'll be back. Okay, I'm back. So it's gonna be like this. I'm on the right side of the bike. Okay. And then so the pedals gotta go up. So this is a drive up right side. So we put the pin across. We gotta go up and down. And then we put it back on like this. Charging system for